Everyone, so welcome back to Dark Souls. This is episode 42. On this episode, we've got to go ahead and drop off our embers to Vamos. And I feel like going to the Valley of the Drakes today. So, first and foremost, let us warp to the catacombs. I might also want some homeward bones before I go. So let's go to, first let's go to Firelink. And I have to go talk to the moss lady, because I think she sells homeward bones. We have to go that way anyways, because I want to go ahead and speak to Domino of Xena. You remember this area? The very first encounter we had in Lordran. Still just as fun as that day. Okay, so I guess we should go speak to Domal first. Okay, made the jump. Come on. Alright. He had to pick, like, the absolute worst spot.
Aye, Shemai. I didn't expect to meet anybody here. I suppose great minds think alike, eh?
Wonder if he has anything new to say to us.
I'm afraid I don't see anything here.
Right, we have to buy something from him. So he's got his set, and the golem set. Smo set. So, I don't know if I've read this. I think I might have, because I'm pretty sure I read Smo set. look, let's look at Artorias' stuff. Helm of Artorias, the Abyss Walker, one of Gwyn's four knights. The death of the helm. Helm's owner can be surmised from the corrosive dark of the abyss, and the musty azure blue tassel, once a symbol of pride and glory. So, according to this description, it is clear that Artorias is dead because of the corrosion of the abyss. What that sort of implies is he was kind of long gone before we found him. It was no longer Artorias at that point. And that's why everyone was so happy that we finished him off.
Well, that is a shame then. But no matter. No, not to worry. Come back again. I'm always available. Not every trade was meant to be. There'll be more in store for...
I do want to get his dialogue, so... maybe I can buy an arrow from him.
I'm afraid I don't see anything here. Thank you. That was a fine trade. I have this funny feeling we'll meet again soon, and we'll make another fine trade.
Well, I just got gypped. Didn't give me anything. That's fine. Just wanted these, lady. Okay, I won't waste one on the way back because there really is no need. But I am going to use one on our way back from the catacombs, as I said. And it'll probably come in handy as we're exploring other areas, too. So without further ado, let's go ahead and run over there. Come on. There we go. We gotta really be careful when we're dealing with these bone wheel skeletons. They are going to, as you can see, be a big problem. Oh god, come on, no! You gotta be kidding me. This is when you ask this. Oh, you fucking... Son of a bitch. Son of a... Dude, I'm done with these skeletons, man. You see that? You see that? So, these shenanigans where you're chasing them around, and then there's like three of them, and they start bone-wheeling the shit out of you. Oh, look at that. Okay. 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 Okay, come here. Finally, got you. Fucking hell. Is that all of them? Please tell me that is all of them. And what did he drop? Oh, another bone wheel shield. Now I can dual wield these. Fantastic. And Vamo should be over here. You know, I probably could have safely ran past all of them, because I'm just going to Vamos, but I can't risk it. It does kind of make you wonder why the large flame ember was in New Londo. It seems like, since New Londo was founded as a place for humans amongst the City of the Gods, that there would be some sort of divine attribute there, or perhaps after it fell you could see something like dark, but it is the large flame ember, which doesn't really make too much sense. We have that ember. We're gonna go ahead and repair our equipment real quick. Oh, great, he sells them. I should have just bought them from him. I'm wondering what we should upgrade if we can make anything unique. Yeah, I could possibly do that. Although I'm going to need Titanite shards. If that'd be all, then be gone with you. You'll spoil my focus. So I'm gonna try to get my scimitar upgraded into a chaotic weapon. Let me go ahead and use this. If I get my scimitar to +5, I can either make Quilax Fury Sword or something else. We will go ahead and do that.
Yes, splendid. Splendid indeed. My, oh my, you precious little thing.
The way he laughs makes him seem so much more sinister than just a normal blacksmith, but I'm going to go ahead and well, I need to purchase some of these. Let's go ahead and buy two of them. And then reinforce the scimitar. And I need three more now. Now I can modify my scimitar to become a fire scimitar. I think this is not what I want, though. Maybe I have to bring it to... I probably have to bring it to the giant blacksmith.
If that'll be all, then be gone with you. You'll spoil my focus.
But I gave him the Chaos Ember. So I'm unsure if... I'm unsure of how that works. I know I can give him the Chaos... I know he can make the Chaos Fury Sword. I'm pretty sure he can make the Chaos Fury Sword. I don't know. Well, I'll just forget that now. It's not really like it's important to me anyways, but what am I doing? I bought an item for this. Time to go back. So I was thinking on this episode, we would go to the Valley of the Drakes because we usually don't explore that area. Ever. I mean, we've walked past it, but we've never actually gone through and killed out all the enemies in it. So, why don't we go ahead and warp to Firelink? Whoops. We're going to take the elevator down, and then once we take the elevator down, we are going to dick around there. So, I've been kind of chilling while I've been doing this series. I've been doing some coding. And I've also been looking at a lot of Bloodborne stuff. Bloodborne is actually my second favorite Souls game after Dark Souls 1. I love it. I think the lore is fantastic. I love cosmic horror. And the fact that it's combined gothic, Bram Stoker-esque, you know, horror tales with cosmic horror is really cool. I've been looking at the Up Close series by Jerk Sans Frontiers, which is a play on Military Sans Frontiers from Metal Gear Solid, by the way. But his videos are incredible. And one thing I've really noticed from him is he really pays a lot of attention to the environment. Now, I think I started out paying a lot of attention with this series, but as we went through, it just kind of devolved into this more middling, just sort of like walkthrough-esque. I share some of my thoughts on some things, and every now and then I comment on design. And that was never really my intention. I wanted to keep it very focused and strong all the way, but I guess I sort of lost sight of that. My hope is to... Well, I can't really revive it much because we've only got a few areas left, but hopefully I can keep talking about some of those things that make this game so interesting, environmentally speaking. So here we are in the Valley of the Drakes. It's off to the side of Firelink Shrine. And it's not really so much a valley as it is a crevice. Or a chasm that... a rift between the land here. That is the way to Blighttown. This down here is the way back to the valley, over to New Londo, from the front, I believe. We have to actually cross the plank first. This is actually also where we got the old witches set, I believe, over there. It's so dark in this valley because of the lack of sunlight that we get, I suppose. But it just feels very spooky and disturbing. So you'll notice there's this giant dragon corpse here. And he's guarding some items. He's actually going to be a bit of a tough customer. You can suspect that he will get back up, and we can even target him. You can see that swing of his did quite a lot to us. You may want to back away and Estus real quick. With 20 flasks, I am confident that we'll do much against him. So just like with the one at the Painted World, the best strategy is just to bait an attack from afar to get the breath weapon out. Once the breath weapon is going, you just hit the claw. And he drops a dragon scale, of course. Over here is the Astora Straight Sword, the Dragon Crest Shield, and just a soul over here. So let's go ahead and look at those two. So we have the Sunlight Straight Sword, which is directly from Solaire, and then the Astora Straight Sword, which is almost a divine weapon of itself. Straight Sword of an unknown knight, likely one of Astora's superior, high-quality weapon with a powerful blessing. We can use this weapon against the skeletomes. The skeletons in the catacombs. I think that's why I was going to say skeletomes. And this will actually knock them down and prevent them from coming back up. The Dragon Crest Shield, I believe this is like the Grass Crest Shield. No, never mind, I'm thinking of something else. This actually just reduces fire damage. Shield of a Nameless Light, likely high-ranked Knight of Astora. One of the Enchanted Blue Shields, the Dragon Crest Shield greatly reduces fire damage. Fantastic. So I think other than that, all we have to do is fight these drakes. And just like all the other flying enemies in this game, if they go off this cliff, their wings will not actually be able to carry them up. Their wings are just kind of aesthetically there to explain why they can do flyby attacks. So these things, they do have quite a lot of health. It takes 3 swings with my plus 15 halberd to, not halberd, my Zweihander to kill them. But you can see that they stagger relatively easily. I'm trying to get them to drop stuff. I think maybe if I just use a humanity, that will aid in that. So the more humanity you have consumed, the higher your drop rate is, by the way. I'm going to try to lure this guy back. You can see that there's the flyby attack. And you can hit them from quite a ways away because of their wings. Their wingspan is part of their hitbox, at least where it connects to their torso. So you can take them out relatively easily. So there's 3 here, and when you pull back, it actually aggroes 2. I'm going to try to Wow, I just got played like a fucking fool there. Did you see what that thing did? Holy shit. So, that was like some fucking Super Smash Brothers fucking Overwatch play of the game shit right there. It juked past me as I was attacking. And what that did was it took my camera and turned it to follow it because I was locked on. And that caused me to turn towards that hole and to swing towards that hole. And when I swing, I take one step, which brings me towards the hole, which causes me to fall. So, good play there, good play. What is slightly annoying about that now is I do have to run all the way back there. But that is a short price to pay. Over there, those are the aqueducts we take to get to Undead Burg and Undead Parish. I think down there is actually the Chasm of the Abyss. I don't know how far or close we are geographically to Darkroot Garden. But I think we're very close because I feel like it must be very close from Ulysseal to New Londo. And this is kind of where those two areas connect. So you can see that these guys actually do drop dragon scales. So if you need dragon scales to upgrade your weapons, this is where you can find them. And he is pushing me dangerously close to that edge there, which is getting me nervous. But let's see, let's deal with this guy now. So I think he's going to actually kill himself. Oh, no. A girl can dream, though. So down he goes. And that's also, by the way, the lock-on, not chiefly the lock-on reason, but the maneuvering during combat is part of the reason why they have knocked out the railings and a bit of the floor here on this bridge, is because they don't want you to fight here. They think it would be more interesting if you had to fight all those at the same time. So I think that is what we're going to do. First things first, we will get fucked, absolutely. And one of them just fell off, which I guess is very nice. So another one goes down, and now it is a cakewalk. I would have liked if that one hadn't fallen off, only because it would have made the fight much more intense, because you could see that I was messing up on my rhythm. And I was actually rolling into the lightning rather than out of it, but yeah. So with that, we've basically finished this area. I know, right? There really wasn't much to it. What's good is you can see this... What's cool is you can see that over here where New Londo is, where the flood was maintained and now these bones have spilled out, there is also a door on the other side, which makes you wonder where this place leads to. If this is another section of New Londo, or perhaps this was just an area that they were attempting at one point to expand outwards. Over here is the... what is that? So over here is the shortcut that'll take us to the basin. And we can't go any further up this mound, but it looks as if this mound specifically is blocking something off. Or it was to fill in the section and then it just sort of slid down. So I don't really know what this place is. If it's connected to the basin, this could potentially be an alternate path into Ulysseal, because the basin would take us to the lake, which would be right next to Ulysseal. And the township. So I think perhaps this is just a path to Ulysseal, and this is how Frampt was able to make his way and bring the Abyss into New Londo. With that, I think what we're going to do is we're going to Homeward Bone back to Firelink. Now, I actually want to check up on Rhea. You might be wondering why I keep checking up on Rhea. Well, if the event happens, then you'll understand why. If it doesn't happen, then I'll explain it to you. So let's go ahead and run back up, and what we want to do is run over to Rhea. Fucking hell, I could have just used the elevator by Petrus. Bah, whatever. The old church and the new church. I don't really know the time span of when the churches were built, per se, but I think it is pretty far apart. One of the big things, by the way, is there is sort of this assumption made. Oh, she's gone. All right, so it happened. Let's go ahead and run back down. You know what? We're going to take the elevator. So we've come up here, and Rhea has gone missing. Now, we know that she was abandoned by Petrus. And it seems like, according to Oswald of Kareem and Patches, there is something Petrus is holding against her, and he's clearly not up to any good. So we are going to confront him.
Oh, I'm sorry. Miracles, was it? Sometimes I lose myself. Pay me no mind.
Huh. Okay. So I guess it didn't happen. Maybe it glitched out. Tell you what, we'll try again next episode, and perhaps it will have occurred then. For now, we are going to make our way up to Anor Londo. And with Anor Londo done, that'll probably be the last thing before we go down to the Kimmel of the First Flame. I don't actually want to warp here, although I wonder, I don't think the Dark Moon Knight is going to have anything new to say to us either.
You have made it back. You were gone so long. Go ahead. You may rest here. Even an undead requires repose. If you require rest, that is.
So, let's actually warp to the Chamber of the Princess. Because this will take us closest to the giant blacksmith. So here we are. This is Guinevere. Let's go ahead and take these elevators down. We haven't been in here in a while. If you recall, this is where we fought Ornstein and Smo. And this is Smo's elevator because it is bigger. Whereas Ornstein's is smaller, which is a nice little touch. According to a timeline video I watched, Anor Londo was built before Gwyn challenged the dragons in the Great War. And in fact, a lot of their architecture was built before then. Now, I think it makes sense of some things as to why the Silver Knights was trained to fight dragons, because if they were trained to fight dragons after the war, when they were all dead, it wouldn't really make any sense. But I don't really like the idea, only because I feel like it doesn't make any sense that the dragons would let Gwyn and his compatriots live in the land while and build these massive castles and stuff before before killing them. Like, as soon as they would have came out of the darkness, like in that cutscene, you know, out of that tree, the dragons would have challenged them. And that's not what happens, you know? In order for the story to stay consistent, then they would have had to leave, and then it wouldn't have been the dragons that were the transgressors. It would have been the I'm getting tired of this guy. I don't think I need to fight him. I don't know what I'm doing. It wouldn't have been the dragons that were the transgressors. It would have been the gods, which is a cool and interesting spin on it, because, you know, maybe the intro cutscene is just propaganda. We're essentially being told something that isn't 100% true. Nope, so the giant blacksmith is on the other side. We've got to kill this asshole, don't we? Before I forget, let me take the gloves off too. And down he goes. Fantastic, fantastic, fantastic. So he's going to drop a demon titanite for us. He's going to drop two. And I think that is all of the prowling demons in the game. And they are now dead. Fantastic. So let me go ahead and put my maiden robe on. Okay, so we actually want to run to the other side to speak to the giant blacksmith. And we've got plenty of souls, so we should be able to ascend anything we so desire. Fuck it, these guys. Fuck you, giant sentinels. Yeah, heal yourself, cunt. You won't be around for much longer, trust me. And I'm not just saying that to be cheeky, I'm saying that because it's going to be true. You'll see soon. Fuck, we want to actually go up the stairs, don't we? We want to go up here. And we want to go out here. Yes, 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 yes. This is the way to the giant blacksmith. My pal. I love this. I love the fact that every single blacksmith we meet, we always have to come down to meet them. And we always hear them hammering first. That's just a nice little touch of consistency. Or theming, really.
Hello, forge I can. Strong I am.
So, the other guy can make fire weapons. What, you can't ascend anything, huh? You know what? Let me go ahead and purchase some titanite shards from him. I need like 7, I think. And I'm going to reinforce this mace, because I should be able to make something out of this. I need 2 more shards. Reinforce weapon. Mace, where are you at? Where are you? Mace. Alright, so now modify equipment. Can I ascend? Motherfucker. I cannot ascend the mace. I think I have to go to Andre. Maybe I have to go to Andre and then ascend from there. Yeah, I don't remember, man. I'm pretty sure pretty sure you just have to get it to +5 to make the boss weapon. Otherwise, these boss souls are kind of useless to us. Yeah, maybe I'll look up how to make these weapons, or what these make. Otherwise, I'll just use them and level myself up. But there is something I want to show you, and I think it might be a good way to end the episode. So I'm going to warp back to the bonfire. And hopefully I rested at the bonfire, otherwise I'm going to look like a retard. Nope. Alright, well, I'll warp there then. Chamber of the Princess. Let's go ahead and rest here. So this is Guinevere, yeah? What if you tried doing something like this? What if you tried to equip a firebomb or something you could throw and throw it at Guinevere? So everything has gone blue here. What's up with that, huh? This bonfire's still here. So the bonfires haven't gone out. Watch this. Oh, fucking hell. That could have been bad. Now, I feel like we still have time to do a bit more on this episode, so I want to just keep going. Even though we probably don't. But everything has gone dark here. The sun has just faded away. And it's not just in the chamber. If you look out to the lighting, everything, the color palette has just swapped to blue. And when we come out here to where those sentinels used to be, they're gone. Instead, we have these knights here. These are the Blades of the Dark Moon. And they've come to exact their vengeance upon us for destroying Guinevere's illusion. Oh boy. So we just got riposted. So we'll kill the ball. We'll kill the Berenique Knight, and I think this guy's gone stuck. There we go. I want to unstuck him. Let's. He's going to try to parry us, and we will jumping attack him. So these guys are good. They give you 5,000 XP a pop, 5,000 souls, etc. Now, if we run out here, you'll notice the sentinels in the entire city, all of the enemies that would have otherwise been here are gone. There's now a fog wall on the other side of there. This brings up a lot of interesting questions. First of all, if that really wasn't Guinevere, and that was just some sort of illusion, because let's face it, we killed her in one hit. Is the sun also an illusion? And if the sun was an illusion here, does that mean it's an illusion everywhere? Let's go run up to the giant blacksmith, because I just want to confirm that he's still around. It would be kind of suck if he was gone. That would mean I would have to use my boss souls, because I wouldn't be able to make any boss weapons. I still hear him. And look at that, we've been invaded. I think we've been invaded by a player. Biggest Dickus. Oh man. What a cool guy. Yep, he's still here. Alright, let's go fight this guy. And we'll call it an episode. So we've been invaded probably by a Dark Moon. And if not, by someone else. Maybe that's why there was a fog gate up. So where are you, Biggest Dickus? You can see that there's another guy down there. Yep, there he is. Was he AFK? I don't really understand what happened there. Also wasn't like the fairest of fights. You did see me equipment swap out of my fashionable gear to this gear. Only because, well, I didn't want to lose because of my equipment. So who is down there? It's actually the Dark Moon Nidus. Yep, you can go ahead and buff your lance, lady.
So it was you, wasn't it? How dare you produce a blade upon a deity? How did you ever get this far? I shall end your suffering here and now. It is the least that I can do.
She drops a Firekeeper soul, and we've been invaded by another person. Biggest Dickus. Same guy, huh? Is he the only Dark Moon? Is he AFK? I don't understand what's going on with this guy. I'm gonna run around behind him so he can't parry me. And take care of him. I honestly think he's not loaded in yet, and that's what his problem is. But I'm gonna go ahead and roll this all the way up. You can see that we can't leave through there anymore the way we came. Oh, we can now, I suppose. I think his invasion was what was stopping us. I thought perhaps that is something that is supposed to happen. Anyways, we want to go ahead and bring this all the way down, 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 down. We want to go down to the Chamber of the Dark Moon. Or the Chamber of the King. I mean, whatever it's called. And we don't want to go up either. So let's make sure we go down. I think we're going to go up. Yep, we're going down. Fantastic. So this path down here will take us to the bonfire. And do I want to continue on this episode? Well, first of all, I think maybe we should spend our souls. We should level up that... Oh, fuck, what the hell happened? Let's try that again. Huh. So I can't... I can't really do that. Anyways, I want to go ahead and put on this ring. Oh, we've been invaded. Okay. We've been invaded by somebody. So this is what happens when you do this to Anor Londo. When you come back here, you'll start to get invaded by people who are Dark Moons. I don't know where he's invaded us. But if you look down there... See these strange candles by this sun-like image. Now, if we had put on the Ring of the Sun's Firstborn, which do we have? Not his Firstborn. Oh, yeah, it is Ring of the Sun's Firstborn. We can enter into that tomb and fight whatever is behind there. Alright guys, so I'm in the Ornstein and Smo boss fight room. I am looking for this invader. But on the off chance that we have a weird occurrence, I'm going to do my salute here. This has been Fahad Saddam, Pixel Icons, signing off. Have a great day. I will try to hunt down this invader. There he is! Ah, what is that? Healer. Fucking dumb. He's gonna heal, I'm gonna heal. Oh my god. He is smart.